Sorry, Covenant. I really don't like you as a quest. I have to look at this badly photoshopped image really fast. Oh, that's the best. Yeah, old Eddie Murphy. I mean, the 80s allowed people to basically be pieces of shit. And you know, the old 80s Eddie Murphy is a very... I mean, especially the Raw stand-up, highly overrated. You know what I mean? I think Eddie Murphy Raw was only funny because he was a crass black gentleman. In much the same way that I think Sam Kinison's shtick was... Hello. Slightly more valid. What are you gonna do? You're getting electrocuted, buddy. Oh, no. I wonder if reactive plates would be better for this build. We could try the reactive plates out. Reactive plates basically just make it so that they do 50% of the damage to them of their melee attacks back to themselves. Yeah, no, George Carlin was never like that, and I don't think that, I don't think that Rodney Dangerfield was either. They weren't homophobic. I mean, you know, it's kind of rough to say that somebody is a homophobic piece of shit when they were a comedian in the 80s. They're probably just doing what they thought was going to help them sell comedy records or whatever. But, you know, obviously, it's highly distasteful. But, yeah, I don't know. Boing, boing, boing. It's like Diablo 3 busting up the graveyard. One of my favorite things to do because you could get experience from multiple hits in a row or whatever. Oh, Mosi, thank you for that follow. Why do I keep not seeing them until I look over? Or not hearing them? I wonder if my alerts aren't playing in my headphones or if I'm just hypnotized by my own shit. Carlin was one of the greats, man. Carlin and Rodney Dangerfield both did something that I have massive respect for, and that's that instead of just getting up there and talking about their shit and delivering their, like, stories in a certain way, which is what most people do when that, as comedians, they get up there and they tell a story and then they kind of tell you their reaction to it. George Carlin and Rodney Dangerfield didn't do that. There's no story time with George Carlin and Rodney Dangerfield for the most part. It was jokes that they wrote, you know. Not seeing them? I don't get it. What was I not seeing? Anthony Jeselnik? I like Anthony Jeselnik. He's come out of fucking nowhere. You know what I mean?
You find those raiders?
When they did, I think it may have been the roast of, let's say, Charlie Sheen.
Mm-hmm.
I can't remember now. Let's see, let's do Taffington. That's fairly near to here, right? Yeah, that's a good connection. Well, you're gonna have to keep doing that crop rotation there, sport, because I gotta scrap your joint. I better kill these roaches first. Yeah, Anthony Jeselnik is really cool. He sort of didn't have much going on. You know, when he was doing the roast that had, oh Jesus, what's the dude's name? I can't remember anyways. Oh, I already killed your roaches. Well, that was nice of me. Yeah, there were a lot of people that got their first gigs through Comedy Central, especially back in the day. It was sort of like an off-brand, you know, I mean, they didn't really have specialty channels except for MTV on cable for a long, long time. And then finally they were like, yeah, let's do a channel for every occasion. And then eventually they realized that a history channel wasn't going to do very well, and so they started releasing shit about ancient aliens. But, yeah, I especially like his bit about, his bit on the thoughts and prayers thing. It's fucking hilarious to me that politicians still even do it. Because it's like a cliche bad joke thing now. It did not used to be like that. It used to be that you needed to show that you were even noticing that there was an atrocious thing that was going on in the world. But people would do that and then they wouldn't do anything else. And now, if that's your reaction to a tragedy, you're a garbage human. You know, it's the equivalent of having your brain tell you that you did a good thing and then and that you've somehow like put yourself towards it. It's like when you decide you're going to change some kick some bad habit or change your life in some way, and the first thing you do is tell all your friends that you're going to do this thing. That actually makes it less likely that you're going to do it, because you've already given yourself props for having done the thing. You know what I mean? Like, as far as your brain is concerned, you've already achieved your goal by telling everybody that you've done it, which was kind of the reason why you wanted to achieve the goal in the first place. Well, that's a shittily placed turret. That's why the thoughts and prayers thing is kind of ridiculous. You're so small in your little webcam window on mobile. I had considered, I mean, I do have a green screen, but I couldn't get it to really work before. And now I might be able to, but this setup was merely temporary for ever. And now, you know, now I'm moving, so I probably won't ever use it. But if I put a green screen on, you wouldn't be able to see any of the shit behind me. I guess it really doesn't make too much of a difference when I'm in, you know, game mode. Oh fuck, I have to go talk to Preston Garvey about this, huh? Well, we'll do that the next time we go back to Sanctuary. We need to start clearing some of these quests out, though. Let's see, what time is it? I wonder how much time we have. We've got an hour left. Do you think we could do more of this? I wonder how far along I would have to get. Is this where you get the Tesla shit? For some reason, I can't remember. I feel like you do this, and then you put Jezebel's head in somebody's body, right? Is this that mission? I can't fucking remember. I'm gonna give it a shot, though. Oh, it's the Fort Hagen satellite array. You're right. Yeah, it's over here. Okay, well, maybe I won't try that tonight, then. I suppose we ought to just go walk over here and turn this in, because the first step is not that far away. Thank you, Isha-sama. I appreciate that. For some reason, I knew it was a... an industrialized location, and I could not remember, but I was trying to think to myself, like, okay, what order do we do this shit in? The first thing we do is... See, it does damage to this guy. It's pretty slow, though. Oh, for fuck's sakes. I was just a little bit worried about there being a suicider up there. Random encounter land, a go-go. Grenades. What the hell are you doing? The lady's just walking along like, this is fine. This is an okay thing to happen to me. I like that I got the experience of this guy throwing the grenade. There goes the dog body. 10 points. Well, I'll tell you one thing that you can do with the completed automatron shit. I mean, the mechanist outfit is not that cool. I'll admit to that. And getting the robots to stop attacking you after you have the ability to get all the robots, that is nice. But it's not that different from Dawn Guard, where you don't get that much for having not really done anything. But you do get the iBot pod, which is nice for when you're doing a build that involves some shit that's kind of, you know, it's kind of specialized, like having the iBot go search out a nuka grenade or something like that. Yeah, the iBot pod is cool. I like that thing. But you're right. It's really not worth it to just to get all the components to build robots. The crafting part is the part that's interesting, but you have to complete at least the first quest to do that. But I think we're a ways away from getting that. We'll try to make that the goal of the stream on over there right now shooting at shit. Oh, this guy has one of the little dongles on his fucking head. Let's see what happens if you follow me over here. Serpentine! Rust Devils do have one thing, though, that you can't get in any other situation. And that's, the intelligence goggles. Fight the fucking dog that's biting you, stupid. Why the fuck does he shoot me? I'm the only person not actively attacking him. What kind of target choosing is that shit? Yeah, you prick. Missile turrets. Gotta have gun nut for missile turrets, dude. I could have built laser turrets, but that's probably not the best choice for this situation. Let's see, there was other robots around here. I kind of wish that it showed, like... I mean, it shows all of the dudes in red, no matter what they are. But, I kind of wish that it showed, like, their bodies in, like, green or something like that. Or hostiles is red, non-hostiles is blue.
Hey, boy. What are you doing out here all by yourself?
I suppose I ought to greet the dog and then send him to Red Rocket, so that that's not in my quest log. Techno dog.
Okay, then. Let's stick together. Hey, how you doing, buddy? Go on home now.
Is it called a build? It's an RPG term. It means, you know, it means a design for a character that you follow, you know. And sometimes the designs are vaguely, how should I put this? They're not particularly, like, rigidly set or anything like that. So, goddamn, there's a lot of you idiots. I can't put any more dudes in Sanctuary Hills. You guys need a bed or something. Oh yeah, I forgot. Unless you greet the dog, there's more rats. Yeah, it's what you basically have in mind for, you know, for your entire character. What their stats are gonna be, what their perks are gonna be, what their, you know, what their equipment is going to be, etc. And it looks like you idiots are about out of food, so I'll plant some of this shit here. All you're living on is gourds and melons over here. That's deeply depressing. Here. I kind of like the barn prefab. It's kind of rough to build a prefab out here, though. You know what I mean? Just because of the way that it's... because of the way that it kind of floats off the ground. It has always bummed me out a bit. Oh, this is far too big. Alright, fair enough. I'll just do a thing. Make you guys feel good inside. Box house, that's all that matters. There you go. I'm not sure if that touches the ground even. Oh yeah, it does. Ever so barely much. Almost, but not quite, doesn't. Secretly Ames, welcome to the stream. I try not to do too much of this shit, but you know how it is. Sometimes you just gotta make a little barracks for your homies. Let's see. I guess that's good enough for now. That was close call. I didn't mean to pick everybody up and have them fight me, but it was a near thing. Why don't we repair our power armor while we're standing here? Oh, XL fame of you. Welcome to the stream as well. I didn't announce it twice, but I did notice it. Terrible shit. Not that. This is what I meant to do.
Something useful, I hope.
Kind of wacky shit now, don't we? That'll probably kill us in the long run. How do I kill people with no weapons? Wish you could turn off the power armor stop. Yeah, I kind of wish that too. Let's try this. Oh, I need to have armor 4 to do that, so I can't do this either. I was going to try it out and just see how it went down, but doesn't look like it's going to work. The reactive plates thing is kind of an interesting concept. The original idea for this build was going to use reactive plates and ricochet to solve all of his problems. But ricochet doesn't work on fucking everybody, and likewise, not everybody is a melee attacker, so. Yeah, crank all that jet out. I ended up buying some fertilizer stuff. I guess, I didn't clear this, huh? I ran in and grabbed the thing and left. Yeah, I bought some fertilizer shipments from Green because I didn't have anything else to spend the money on. Somebody got banned while I wasn't looking. You fucked up. I don't know who you are, what you did, but you had every fucking reason to get your ass thrown the fuck out of here. fish sweats. Do fishes sweat? That doesn't seem reasonable at all. Get down from that roof, you goof. Who the fuck is you? Who the fuck is that? Sorry. I was auto-walking. What's your deal, stupid?
Let's trade some things.
Sure thing.
I'm taking your caps. Oof. You alright? You seem alright. I don't know, it looked like there was Band City over there. We still have plenty of beds, right? Yeah. This is the max amount of people I can have in this settlement because of my charisma. Oh, I came up here to turn this into Preston Gravy with his fucking shotgun for some reason.
You know that settlement you sent me to help? They've decided to join the Minutemen.
That's great news. I knew you were the right person for the job. By the way, I don't think I ever told you what happened to the Minutemen.
No, I don't give a fuck.
How I ended up.
You are going to remain the last Minuteman. How does that feel, Preston? Damn it, they're always all taken because they're the closest ones to where I work. I know we don't need more beds, but goddamn you people. Oh, I need to sleep for 8 hours. That's what I'm doing here. Your cable modem won't even look for the signal. Wasn't it you who fucking bricked two routers in like 10 minutes? I recall that conversation. Did I play through the DLC yet? No. Nope, I haven't done much of a Far Harbor. Not with this build, I haven't played through the DLC at all. I guess that's not true. I've done a little bit of the DLC. Let's eat some of this shit. Cook some of this shit. We did a little bit of the DLC with this character earlier in the stream. Like, not in the stream, but... Let's see, how should I put this? Where the fuck did I get all my power armor? Did I get out in here? That's weird. We've done, a handful of the quests in Far Harbor. I've gone through all of Automatron. That was a build wherein I didn't do any killing. I just let the robot companion do all the killing. And I never, ever, ever killed anything except for having a robot do it for me. Let's see, now what should we do? The hallucinogen thing probably wouldn't be too bad. Let's try to do some of this stuff that's, you know, on a par with where we're at in the game. Which one is this one? The Boston Public Library? Okay. It probably would be okay to try to get Nick Valentine out at this point. Let's do that. Who do I dislike most in Fallout 4? Probably Marcy Long. That death long.